Sid Meier's Pirates is one of those games that really stuck out to me. As soon as I heard about the game, I knew I had to go and play it. While I know this game is a remake of the 1987 game with the same name, I'm not able to compare the two since I never played it and I really wasn't alive at the time to play it anyways. Regardless of the country that you pick out to start with, you and the crew mutiny against the captain and your destiny lies in your own hand. I'm actually being serious here though. The game is an open-ended sandbox where your career ends on your own terms or when you meet an unfortunate demise. I have to be honest though, this game is pretty atmospheric. I really do feel like a pirate sailing the high seas. Coupled with the many activities to do in the game, it really adds to the immersion factor. So the first thing I'd like to talk about is the naval combat. Honestly, it's pretty good. It's pretty satisfying. I like the different weapon types. When you upgrade your ship, you can use chain shot to destroy the sails. You also have grape shot if you want to destroy the crew members, and the regular old round shot if you want to destroy the hull. This will happen more often than not, but if you collide with the ship, you'll enter a duel mode with the captain of the other ship. It's pretty simple, especially when you first start the game, since the game is pretty easy, honestly. The combat is fairly simplistic. You just press a button for low attack, one for medium attack, one for high attack, to jump to avoid the low attack, to parry, or to duck. It's very simple, easy. You can taunt as well. Nothing too complicated. It gets the job done, but I could have preferred a little bit. So if you defeat the captain, you get the ship. Sometimes you'll get crew member that want to join your crew, special crew members, some that can make your ships faster or make your gunpowder, your cannon stronger. After that, you can look and just loot what you want, take all the food, take the goods, and then go to a port and sell it, and you're pretty much living the life of a pirate. However, that's just the very basic gist of what this game has to offer. There is a lot to do and a lot to keep you busy. One of the things you'll be doing a lot is going to towns, and of course you can visit the governor there. Once you visit him, he'll either ask you to take him to a port nearby, or he'll give you an assignment, tell you how you're doing, give you promotions, scold you if you are attacking that country's ships, let you dance with his daughter, and a few other notable things. For the romances, regardless of how ugly or how hot she is, it plays out exactly the same. And because of that, I still recommend that you dance with everyone, because there are some great benefits even if you are married. We're pirates after all, so who the hell cares about chivalry? Plus, you can earn some awesome loot that'll be of real benefit to you. You also get some rumors about criminals, but we'll get into that later. The dancing minigame is fairly basic. It's just a simple timing minigame. Press the correct button at the right time or look like a left-footed buffoon in front of everyone at the ball. It's pretty forgettable, but if you take my strategy, you'll be playing this a lot. You can practically memorize the steps after a while without the need for her to point. The next thing you can do at the town is visit the tavern. This is very important, especially in the early goings. You're gonna wanna have a good crew, so always go back here and try to get as many people as you can. You could also talk to the bartender and the barred maid. They'll give you rumors and they'll let you know about what's going on, people's whereabouts, where you can find some pirates, and a couple little other tidbits here and there. The dude in the back is honestly pretty cool. You can get some treasure maps from him, as well as some items that can really benefit you if you got the gold. You also have the merchant to sell your loot gained from the ships. While trading is not a main focus in this game, it could be pursued if you choose to. Last but not least is the shipwright. Here you can upgrade your ships, sell them, and repair them. Each port offers a different upgrade, so choose wisely. While most of this stuff remains fairly consistent, there are some variables. Sometimes at the taverns you'll be fighting an annoying captain. If you beat him, more crew would want to join your team. The tavern is also the same spot where you can find the criminals. Thankfully, most of these criminals are a little bit stronger than the regular pirates and the annoying captains, so they give a bit more of a challenge. Now, once you defeat them, you get even another option in it. He can either offer you an item or a bribe, or you can have him stand trial and get a gold sum. In the game, there are some escort missions that you can undertake. They involve protecting the ship from hostile ones. Most of the escorts you will encounter involve ending wars or beginning them, so these can really change the dynamics of the game. English and French can become friends, and mass hysteria can ensue. There are many ways to earn gold in this game, and while raiding is the main way to make money, finding buried treasure can work just as well. From the map, you need to use the landmarks to find out where exactly the treasure is located. From there, you take the landing party, and the search begins. Once you find the place, your crew will automatically begin to dig it up. The expeditions are well worth it, as this chest alone was found to have 9,000 gold coins. That's enough to keep my crew happy for a while. And that brings me to my biggest complaint, crew morale. If you have too many people on board, they begin to get mad, as well as if you aren't making enough gold. Sometimes they get mad when we have only been on sea for less than a year, especially on higher difficulties. To get rid of this, you have to split the plunder with your crew, and after 6 months, you are back sailing the seven seas with your flagship and only a handful of people. The game also has a storyline, and it involves finding your lost family members. You collect pieces of the maps from Baron Raimundo and find your four lost members the same way you find buried treasure. Following this story provides a large bonus at the end, but I never felt the need to pursue the storyline. It's completely optional, by the way. One last notable feature I would like to talk about are the siege battles. When you are attacking a city, you enter into a turn-based tactics mode. This rarely happens, but it is a route you can decide to pursue. You need a lot of crew as well to successfully be able to take over a city. Mechanically, it works very well. Use cover to your advantage, flank people, use the terrain to your advantage, and so on. I wish this was done more often and expanded on as well. Heck, this mode could have been its own little standalone title. If you win a battle twice, you will get the ability to appoint a new governor of a different colony if you would like. This is pretty much an instant promotion, so I certainly recommend it if you are trying to rise through the ranks. When you finish the game, you get a summary of your notable actions. Depending on how well you did in the game will determine your final rank. You can also rewatch some cutscenes in the game if you would like to. Once you've beaten the game, you will have some more options to play around with. Most notable here is the starting date. Each one will have different cities in different areas controlled by different nations. While this tries to offer more variety, you will pretty much be doing the same thing in your career. And that is Sid Meier's Pirates. Honestly, it's not a bad game, but it is a very repetitive one, especially if you play it for too long. You eventually just keep doing the same tasks over and over again, and I never really felt the need to mix up what I was doing. If I stuck to one thing, if raiding was giving me the most money, I would stick to that. I never felt the need to really change what I was doing or try anything new. Sure, there are a few things that I haven't mentioned, but they're kind of like secrets, so I want the players to figure out when they play the game what they are. So my overall score is a 7.5 out of 10. It has a lot of things going right for it, but what kills it for me is the repetitiveness and the annoying crew sometimes. But overall, I'd recommend it, especially if you're a fan of pirate games. And there's not really that many great pirate games out there. This is Powerhouse, signing off.